Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make another art journal page. I started spraying a piece of ultra smooth cardstock with Distress Oxide spray, and then I spray some water. I dry it a bit with my heat tool, I blot, and I spray some water and dry it again until I get a stained looking background. And you can make this as a card too, of course. And just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can also find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And you can see that by blotting and drying, the background gets a much softer color. Also, the water helps to make the spray oxidize, which adds to the soft look. I have a postcard stamp. My paper is completely dry now. I add a stamp on the paper and I use the glue stick to make sure it stays put. And then I use archival ink, vintage photo, to stamp a few times. This way I can make a stamped image without having to press too hard. I turn the paper and I measure where it needs to go. And then I stamp the postcard again. And the fun thing is that you can add more ink in different spots to get color difference. And I think it all adds to the old look. I cut the cards apart, just wiggling with the scissors, to get sort of a curvy edge like on old postcards. And I will come back to these later. First, I go on with the background. I spray about half of the card with the peeled paint spray, and then I come in with some water drops by squeezing the Distress sprayer halfway, and I use the heat tool to dry, and then I spray some more water. Now, once you added the color, you can take the card out of the box so it doesn't get wet and your box stays in good condition. I also blot to get lighter spots. I want the background with lots of texture. Then I dry the card. When you want to layer colors, you add on a dry layer, so wet on a dry layer. And when you want to blend, you can work wet on wet. Now, when it's dry, I turn it and I'm going to add the next color. And I spray the other corner with color. I'm going to do the same, so I spray some water, I dry the ink and I blot, and I add some more water drops. Just take your time to play around a bit and see the texture building up. And here you can see the texture and gorgeous layers. I'm going to add some more color with another stamp, and I just do some freehand stamping with the same ink colors. On with the mini postcards. I have a little candle and I'm going to make the burnt edges. This is a bit smelly and you have to be careful because it's a flame and I'm going to work with paper. So you could take this outdoors. Over here it's raining, so that's not an option today. I am going to burn the edge of the card in parts. It's very important as I want to control the burnt edges. I start with a part and then I blow out the flame and it keeps smoldering a bit, so watch it very closely. And I blow until the flame is out. I just wipe away the gray ashes on the edge. Now you don't have to do this, you can ink the edge. I just wanted to show you this as I've done this when I was younger and I like the burnt edge look, and not so many different inks were available then, and I hardly ever stamped, so I didn't have many inks. As you can see, I wipe the edge and it stains black on my finger, so keep that in mind too. So I keep burning the edge, and here is a little time lapse where I do the rest of the card. I'm going to finish the page and I add a tape to my mini card and I add the first one to the page. I crunch up strips of paper that I cut to get a softer look, and I was thinking about a stack of old cards like love letters that people in the movie saved with a ribbon in a drawer or a box. So I'm going to add the paper strips over the first card and I measure with the second card where it needs to go. And I tape the ends to the back. I have foam to the back of the other card for extra dimension and I add it on top. I add a printed sentiment. And I add with some vintage drops. They dry matte, which adds to the vintage look of the page. Now my page is done. I hope you are inspired to make something pretty yourself. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.